Hi Chi, how are you?
Doing well.
You have some exciting stuff over here, 3D athlete tracking.
Yep.
And I always imagined, is it just a gimmick or is it really valuable for sports and maybe even beyond sports?
Yeah.
Can you explain why is this so amazing to have for athletes and even beyond athletes?
Yeah, I guess I'll start at the top. So whether this is a gimmick or not, the reason this is important, so essentially 3D athlete tracking is a software solution for markerless motion capture. So typically motion capture in the past is pretty difficult to do. It's pretty cumbersome. There's a high barrier to entry. You need to have a lab or a capture volume set up. You need to put actors or athletes in these suits with ping pong balls on them, right? All these sensors, right? This is difficult. This is hard to do. But now, thanks to Intel Technologies and thanks to our AI platform, you can capture human movement. You can analyze human movement with no sensors, no markers, no suits, just ordinary cameras and AI. So yeah, this has huge implications for sports, but also for healthcare, retail equipment fitting, all these industries that you couldn't utilize this and you couldn't obtain this data before, now you can.
And explain me how it works.
Yeah, so essentially we use AI computer vision to detect humans in the frame. From there, we detect the key points on the body. So we're tracking about 20 key points from the head all the way down to your feet.
Mm-hmm.
And then from those key points, we're able to overlay a skeleton over that. And then with all that information, we're able to extract biomechanics data. So we can enable anything from a one camera device setup like we have at this demo, all the way up to a nice multi-camera broadcast setup with machine vision cameras. It's camera agnostic, it's all AI, it doesn't matter.
And yeah, here you have a simple camera, it's a good one, but it's a simple one, it's
exactly
under $100, so it's very easy. And I tried it myself, no preparation, no sensors, nothing. And how is it used? So is it used for scouting? Is it used for real-time analytics at sports events? Or tell me.
Yeah, so we have a bunch of use cases that it's being used for currently. You touched on one big one for us, which is scouting. So there's an application that allows people to record themselves doing soccer drills. We've partnered with a bunch of teams in the Premier League, and they're actually scouting the next generation of talent with markerless motion capture, with 3D athlete tracking. And they're getting access to talent that was previously inaccessible before, right? Remote corners of the world. You would never get a scout to fly there. You would never get a scout to see you. Now you can bring yourself to the scout, essentially.
But how does that work? Because I just record somebody with my camera, and they need to connect through the cloud to the platform.
Exactly. So
that's
we
it.
We rely on the camera from the mobile device.
Okay.
We have our algorithms and our SDK in the cloud. All of our architecture can be hosted in the cloud as well. So we simply take that video from that mobile device, we do the processing in the cloud, and then when we're able to return that data back to the user.
And you can compare the skills and the movements with the top athletes.
Exactly.
And see how closely they are to top athletes and can score them, and whether they are in places in the middle of Africa, whether they are in the city of New York, it doesn't matter. If you have somebody with a camera,
exactly,
you can scout them.
Yep.
And you can analyze it. It's Moneyball.
Right on the money.
Yeah, Moneyball, so everything is tracked and you can define already based upon real movements if somebody has the talent or not, based on data and
exactly,
not on a scout who says, I think he's good.
Yep, it's objective data too, right? Scouting, it also relies on the fact that that person has to have the perfect game on that day.
Yeah.
If they have an off day, the scout might not realize their potential.
Correct.
And then that potential will go unrealized. Now we have objective biomechanics data. And now these players can get scored, rated, analyzed, and benchmarked ultimately against the people that they're trying to replace. So it's a pretty cool use case for scouting.
Next to scouting, other use cases?
Yeah, so if we think about human potential, right? So you could think about a coach and an athlete's relationship. A lot of the language you hear around sports, it's not recognizable to an outsider.
Mm-hmm.
So let's say you're a track and field athlete, you're doing a jumping movement. Your coach might say, hey, come down the runway with some more speed and then take off at a more severe launch angle.
Correct.
To someone else, we might not know what that means. The athlete might not know what that means. But if you're able to put data behind what that means, think about what they could do from there. So we find that with more precise inputs, you could get more precise outputs. And that's what motion capture without any sensor suits or markers allows for, right?
And makes the, let's say, the coaching more objective, because you can show it immediately, say, okay, this is how your movement works. This is the data. This is how you compare with what we want to achieve with another top athlete where you want to compare with, maybe the one you need to compete with in the coming weekend.
Yep.
So you can compare everything on the spot, which makes training much more effective.
Yep.
Because you can define the target, measure it, and act according it, and see immediately if you have the results.
100%. Yeah, you're hitting the nail on the head in terms of we're taking motion capture and all this biomechanics information out of the lab and onto the field where it's actually actionable and where it can be used.
I love these use cases. Do you have more?
Yeah, absolutely. I could go on for days. Another use case that we're very, very excited about is health. So if you think about rehabilitation, for example, let's say you're doing a crazy exercise. I don't know your sport of choice.
I had an injury 2 months ago with my skiing and my muscle was teared apart.
Oh, so, yikes.
And
okay.
I recovered. You see me sporting. But
yeah, you're looking good.
Yeah, but it's still hard and painful.
Yeah. So let's say you do the surgery. You come out on the other side of the surgery. Now your surgeon, your clinician, whoever is in charge of your rehab protocol has now prescribed you a bunch of exercises. Right, typically how that procedure goes is you'd go into the clinic a couple times a week, a couple times a month, you perform some exercises, and then your clinician checks in, they view how you're doing, and then they see, okay, this person is behind schedule, on schedule, ahead of schedule, right?
If they see it, because I've done many exercises and say, oh, you have to do this exercise, and say it's not working.
Yep.
Oh yeah, but you have to do it more often, or they cannot really get to the point how to coach you. And
exactly.
This really solves it.
So there's a couple different problems, right? There's rehab compliance, so the compliance of the movements, there's the data of the movements. All of this can be solved using a technology like 3D athlete tracking.
Yeah.
So imagine instead someone who, a scenario where you don't have to go into the clinic, you don't have to fake these movements, you can just open your laptop screen, your camera and your laptop screen captures the movements that have been prescribed to you, and now your doctor can see A, are they actually complying to the rehab protocol, and then B, they have the biomechanics information. So, I can see on their sit to stand movement that they're still favoring their left side over the right side. I might need to prescribe additional movements or do some things on my end to help fix that issue. So there's so many issues that can be resolved with motion capture that's now out of the lab and into the home.
Geo-independence, whether you are in the south of Spain, whether you're at the beach, whether you are close to the hospital, it doesn't matter.
Exactly.
And makes it much more efficient, even for the sport or every person that needs to basically get back on track.
Exactly.
And now in business, next to, let's say, sports, healthcare, is it also used in business?
Yeah, if we think about a business use case that makes us excited, it's around industrial ergonomics. So if you think about how great is it that you can order something and get it 2 days later, right?
Yeah.
That's amazing. So we have all these warehouses, we have all these factories with people that are doing a lot of manual labor to ensure that, hey, we're getting the stuff that we ordered on time, right? But you can imagine people are picking up boxes, they're lifting boxes over their head, and we don't necessarily have great ways to prevent injuries, and we don't have great ways to prevent that from happening, and recommending and training people on proper ways to do movements in the future. So imagine a scenario where you set up cameras in your factory or your warehouse, you're capturing the movement of your employees, and then you could prevent and you could draw correlation between the way that people move and then the injuries that result from that, so you can prevent injuries. And you can also train people to do movements correctly in the first place. So there's a lot of things in that area as well that get us really, really excited.
Yeah, and even injuries, for example, with football, sometimes they get a tackle and they don't know they're injured. But on the movement, you can see that they've been injured. I've seen this case already. And with the data, they know already, okay, something is wrong based upon this tackle that they had, but they don't know yet. And they can basically predict that this person is going to have a problem later on. Another one which I saw in the Netherlands, they just launched it, is with fraud detection. So in retail shops, people, if they make a movement and say, hey, they put something into their pocket, it's detecting, they get an alert. And based upon this alert, they can say, I'm sorry, can we see what's in your pocket? Because we expect that you probably have something in your pocket which you didn't pay for.
Yeah.
So once I see this, there is so many great
cases.
The
mind starts racing, right?
Yeah, and I think you can go on and on and on with these cases.
Yep.
So if you have a case, contact us and say, hey, this is a great case, because I think there's hundreds of cases here where it can help.
But exactly.
I think we can talk for hours about this.
We could indeed.
Chi, thanks a lot. I'm going to the next booth. It's great insights and I love it.